So I'm here with Rob Andrew, the Chief Executive of Sussex County Cricket Club. Welcome to Latest TV News, Rob. You've got a big development going on here, haven't you? And it's due to start pretty soon. So tell us about what's going on around the ground.
Yeah, well, we got planning permission last week for a master plan for the ground, which involves phase one, which is the pub site, which is going to get demolished and going to replace with a new pub on the ground floor and residential above and some office space at the rear. So it's quite a big development. Yeah. That's all outside the cricket ground. And then phases two, three and four, we come into the cricket ground and we've got plans for a new conference and event space sort of in this corner behind this stand here.
Yeah.
And then coming out onto the ground, we'll knock a few of these seats down. And then some more permanent seating up at the north end of the ground where we haven't got any at the moment and we currently bring temporary seating in.
Yeah.
And then some more permanent seating over in that corner. Yeah, so once we've done phase one, which is the residential bit where the pub is outside the ground, we're going to come into the ground and then knock off this lower set of seating. And there's going to be a new conference and event hospitality space, sort of sat basically where this space is now, where we are. And our office space, which is just in behind there, that building is going to come down as well. So there'll be a new two-storey match day hospitality and non-match day conference and event space sort of coming into this corner between the pavilion, the old pavilion, and that bit of the stand, because it's the best part of the ground that we can put some really quality space in.
And I think that's important because it's people want a whole match day experience, don't they, really? At all sporting events, so that's kind of really going to enhance your match day offer.
Well, it's going to do two things. It's going to enhance the match day offer, which is important from a revenue point of view, but also create a much better facility for non-match day revenue, because we don't play much cricket, you know. It's not a 365 day a year sport, so we have to find ways of driving revenue in other ways for the rest of the season. It's a sort of, you know, a long term master plan, but started with phase one. Phase one is the key, which we will start later this year. We'll prepare the site for demolition in the summer and start hopefully building in the autumn.
There's a lot of homes there, isn't there, going in at the front there with that pub. So how many new dwellings are we talking about?
There's 37 new dwellings. Yeah. So it's a 9-storey building. It's quite a size, same sort of size as our neighbours. But 37 dwellings, a new pub and 12,000 square feet of offices.
Yeah. And what else is going on in around the cricket ground? Because obviously cricket's gone up the sporting agenda after the World Cup win, so you expecting a lot more people to come to the matches?
Yeah, well, we were very well supported anyway in our county championship. We've got a good membership. Our T20 matches are sold out, so if you know, we've got a T20 starting at the end of May and selling well, so if people want to come to the T20, they need to get buying tickets. And we've also got a lot of women's cricket here. This is a real centre for girls and women's cricket in Sussex, and we have 5 big women's matches, 2 England internationals and 3 matches in the new 100 ball competition for the women's team. So the Southern Region, Southern Brave team will play here. So we expect good crowds for that as well. And obviously the odd concert as well to try and squeeze in.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So what's the timeline for these new plans then? We're going to get spades in the ground, what, later on this year, and the old pubs going to get knocked down, isn't it?
The site is vacant now. The pub have moved out. There's a pub and an old house and an old industrial building at the back. So we've got planning permission, we'll spend the next few months preparing the site for demolition. There's a bit of work to do before it gets demolished, and then hopefully in the summer we'll clear the site. We've obviously got to work around cricket and concerts and keep the business going.
Yeah.
And the plan at the moment is probably in the autumn to start digging a hole and getting the construction underway. This is where the new development, the residential and commercial block's going to be. So there'll be a new pub on the ground floor, new flats above, and then some office space at the rear. So that's going to be... this whole corner is going to get redeveloped as part of the master plan on this bit before we go into the ground.
Like all sporting organisations, you're looking for extra revenue streams, aren't you? So that's probably quite key to your master plan.
Yes, yeah, it is. I mean, a lot of this development is around long-term finance and long-term sustainability of the cricket club, creating a new income for the club, not only in the commercial office and new pub, but in the new conference and event space. We'll be building a brand new 5-star hospitality space for cricket matches, and then conference and event space for other non-cricket activities. So it's like all sports, you know, it's all about driving as much revenue as you can to make sure that in the end that it's a sports club, but it's a business, and we've got to keep driving more revenue.
Yeah, you've got a key site here as well. It's right in the centre of the city, actually, isn't it? It's really nice.
Yeah, it's a great ground. It's been here. I mean, it's been in Hove since 1839.
Yeah,
it's been on this site since 1872. So it's nearly 150 years actually played here. So it's a fantastic historic cricket club and a site. We want to stay in the centre of Hove, and this plan gives us a chance to do that.
Yeah, we've got a new season coming up then in the summer. How are preparations going? In fact, we can hear a bit of the preparation behind us.
Yeah, it's pretty tough. It's pretty tough for cricket groundsmen at the moment. It's the wettest winter I think anybody can remember, and we could do with a bit of warm weather and a bit less rain.
Yeah, and moving ahead, really, you've been in the post since January 2017. So how's that all going, leading a major cricket club?
Yeah, I'm loving it. I'm a big cricket fan, have been. Played a lot of another sport, but I still play a bit of cricket. And this is a fantastic club. It's in a great part of the country. It's in a great city. And the 3 years has been, I can't believe how quickly it's gone. This will be the start of my fourth season. We've got some improvements to do on the field, but we're working on that with Jason Gillespie, our head coach. So we've got some big names. Jofra Archer's probably the biggest name that we've got here. We've just re-signed the likes of Ollie Robinson and Ben Brown for long-term contracts. So we're in pretty good shape. As always, you want to get better, but that's just the nature of sport.
Yeah, and you expect an uplift from the World Cup win, are you, from last year, do you think, in terms of attendance? You were attended anyway, but...
There's a massive interest in cricket at the moment. You know, the World Cup was phenomenal, the Ashes series last year. There's the new 100 ball competition this year, which is coming in. BBC are getting more involved in cricket again, which is obviously very good from a terrestrial point of view. There's just a bit of a buzz at the moment. The club's in pretty good shape. It's in very good shape, actually. And obviously the excitement of the development gives us something to focus on. We'll probably be talking about that for a few years as it comes to fruition.
Yeah.
I think the sport's in pretty good shape. A lot of talk about girls and women's cricket, which is really on the up.
Yeah.
You know, there's 85,000 in the Melbourne Cricket Ground watching the women's T20 final last Sunday.
Yes.
Australia against India. England women's cricket's very strong. Women and girls cricket in Sussex is very strong, and we see that as a massive growth area in the next decade. So all in all, you know, fingers crossed, we just keep working hard and trying to enjoy ourselves as well.
Yeah, and just funny, you're competing a bit against football, aren't you? But I can see them both, they can both kind of, they're both big sports, aren't they? And I think they can live together.
I think in a city like Brighton, obviously it's great to see the football club in the Premiership. You know, there's lots of supporters of both teams, and lots of the board of the football club are cricket fans, and the same here. And you know, Brighton's a big enough city to support two sports. Obviously, it helps that one's a summer and one's a winter.
Yeah.
And I think it's great for the city. It's great for the city that there are two well-renowned sporting clubs, you know, doing their best to carry the name of the region forward.
Yeah, okay, we'll leave it there, Rob. Thanks for talking to today, Stephen. Yes, cheers.
My pleasure.
Thanks a lot. Thanks.